All right. Hello, hello. Yeah. Hi. I know I talk about this every single time, but it's really weird to not have someone else to talk to. I'm so used to like our normal way to talk, you know, way to open. I'm not a really good thing listening to that. that I'm just not all of a sudden ready for this. But hi, I'm Kels. I'm the one that's obviously behind the controller. Usually I have two other people that I stream with, but both of them are busy tonight. So we're going to do some Silver Case. So we will, if you have a question to talk about during pre-show banter, let me know as I do my intro, and I will kick off with it. Otherwise, I once again have the random question generator. We can go through like three or four, and then get going on this because, wow, this game is getting a little bit crazy. I think we're getting close to the end. Kind of feels that way at least. But so let's see. Thought I had an announcement at the beginning, and now, of course, I can't remember it. So, never mind. Let's go into pre-show banter once again. If you have a question, please feel free to put it in the chat, and I will answer it. But let's fire up. Oh, hey. First question: what freaky dreams did you ever have that you wanted to be real? A good question. I have, like, when you say freaky dreams, like, the first dream that comes to my brain is a dream that I very, very, like, I want to preface this. I do not want to be real, not a serial killer, all of that. I feel like this is the earliest I've ever had to say that on these streams, but, you know, it happens. But, like, the freakiest dream I've ever had, and this isn't quite answering your question, so I do apologize. But the freakiest dream that I ever had was I was going, so I think I've mentioned for my university, I worked at the like construction center for a little bit. So basically I got to be involved with all of the different buildings that the university was building and everything. And I had this dream when I was working there that, like, I went on site to one of the buildings that was being built, because we got to do that occasionally, and found out that, like, instead of, like, concrete and cement and brick and all of the things that you normally build buildings out of, it was just a bunch of dead bodies. And I remember being horrified, and I do not know why that dream has stuck with me, but it absolutely stuck with me, and I don't know why. So, you know, if you are out there building buildings with dead bodies, please don't. I'm sure there are better alternatives. But clearly I do not want that one to be real. I did have a dream after playing too much Mirror's Edge that, like, the entire city of Tokyo, like, instead of just walking around normally, like, we all did parkour in order to get around. And that was pretty cool. Like, the almost, it feels weird to say the art style of the dream, but, like, it was kind of the art style of the dream even matched. Like, it was all black and white, and then the things that you would use to, you know, like, do cool parkour moves on were in red. And I should also point out, I don't know how to do parkour, so I don't know how real I want this dream to be in hindsight. But we'll go with that one, because that was actually kind of cool. Feel free to share yours. I'm always happy to hear, see, etc., etc. Thank you for the question. Let's do two more. Exactly, like, the part that I want to be real is possibly just doing parkour at all. You know, like, that would be cool if I could just wake up and learn how to do parkour, but there, in order to learn how to do parkour, I feel like you have to do a lot of falling. And I'm not really into, like, throwing myself on the ground for fun. Maybe other people are. Maybe that's their thing. But that's just not mine. All right. So, We're going with a different random conversation question generator this time. It is an ESL one. Don't know why I decided to go with that, but let's generate ourselves a question. How would you describe the style of your home? So I've lived at this current apartment for 2 years now, and I still have boxes I haven't unpacked. I look like I've still just moved in, to be like 100% honest. I don't have anything on my walls. I don't do any like interior design. I look literally like I'm about to move next week still. Or like I just haven't unpacked. Like there are boxes that I have not unpacked yet in my house. And it's not great. It's not a good thing. But when I first moved in, I hit a really bad thing of depression. And so I didn't do any unpacking. Like, it was only about 6 months ago that I finally unpacked my closet and stopped living out of my suitcases. So I do have mess as well. Like, ADHD brain, it doesn't like clutter, but it likes to set things places in piles. And it is not fun to clean up. I'm just going to point that out. So, how would I describe the style of my home? New mover is where I guess we'll go with that. All right, let's do one more. That's a yes or no question. How many pairs of shoes do you have? You know, I've never really been a big shoe person, but I am someone who will take everyone else's hand-me-downs, which is probably not a great habit of mine. So, like, I've got shoes that don't even fit that people have been like, hey, do you want these? I think I've got a couple pairs of boots that I haven't worn. I have 2 pairs of tennis shoes. So I probably have, like, 8 or 9 pairs, I would say. Like, I have some formal shoes. I've got a couple of pairs of heels. Do slippers count as pairs of shoes? Are they shoes? I mean, you do wear them on your feet, but am I giving everyone an existential crisis? Okay, that is amazing. So the comment is, there's a big styrofoam planet Earth nailed to my wall that I took from my middle school graduation dinner that had a space disco theme. And like, number one, space disco sounds incredible. Like, that sounds like a great theme. But also, like, that sounds like great decor is all I have to say. You can, no matter what, you can always say that your room is space themed, or I guess space disco themed. So, all right, that's 3 questions. I think we've got other more interesting stuff to get to now that I've answered how many pairs of shoes I have in my closet. So let's do our recap. So under the username Turtle Guy, we tried and failed to get the scoop on Kamuinet, then complained about the internet generation at the bar. Yeah, we had some boomer conversations. We then got emails about a user named Slash who the bat caught in a trap. If you remember correctly, Slash was the hacker that we asked to look into the bat in the first chapter. So, the hacker got hacked. We met the bat in person, and after he talked about the various syndicates fighting over the Kamui stuff, he pulled a gun on us and somehow died. Also, we got pomegranates from our loving mother, who we haven't spoken to in 3 years because we are an awful son. And also, do not forget, we gave our turtle to Erika. Like, shit is going down on the Morishima side. I'm scared. It's so scary. We know that things are going to go down on the transmitter side then, so it's going down, y'all. Okay, that is also amazing. So every year for theme day, we begged for space disco, and we finally got it in graduation. I spent the party grabbing balloons one by one and hiding them behind the space car in a big pile. That sounds like the greatest way to spend a middle school graduation dinner. I don't think I had a middle school graduation dinner, but I did have a high school graduation dinner. And let me just say, I did not behave during it. I definitely made some chaos. In hindsight, now as someone who would probably have to clean that up as an adult, I would not have done that. But I remember, like, there were all of these streamers put up, and like I sat there and would like see how long I could sit there and tug on one before someone noticed, because like there was like 80 people at this thing, and ended up taking like this giant chunk of them down, and I still, like, in hindsight, do not feel great about that, but stupid high schooler stuff. All right, let's go into case number 5 on the transmitter side. On to Life Cut. It's really weird. So, if you may notice, holy shit. My dude, are you okay? Anyways, ignoring that horrifying face for a second. So if I sound a little bit different, it's because I'm using my other headset, because I think I've finally figured out how to get audio to the other guys. We'll see if that actually works, but, all right. It was late in the year of 1999, and the impact of the method tank was already a thing of the past. Fierce winds from a hurricane rocked the shores of the islands. Tomalu Uehara suddenly vanished from the hospital where he was in custody, announcing his unexpected recovery. In the A1 district, at the center of the 24 wards, after a month-long silence, Kamui murders 7 important government officials. Even now, he remains at large. Tadafumi Kuramochi, the Ministry of Education Supreme Advisor. Minori Sakurai, temporary League of Nations Commander. Daisaburo Taki, former International Environment Agency Vice Minister. Collect Lab Curator Kanji Ishino, Youth Education Center. Chief Physician Tokuzen Umihara, St. Beckham University Hospital Psychiatry Department. Victoria Therapy Representative Shogo Yoshimura. And Republican Party Development Authority Chief Yotitsune Onuki. All officials who have made great contributions to the country. And yet, Kamui isn't showing any signs of slowing down. Kamui runs around committing serial murders. He gets off on the reaction to these bizarre crimes, disrupting the stability of the network, like some old-school killer's been revived. Seems like punishment for the method take rebellion. That's all this crazy son of a bitch is. Well, our worlds have collided. Morishima is in. I guess technically our worlds collided in the first chapter, too. Or I guess it was the second chapter. All right. The ethereal uneasiness and irritation that deeply and silently permeate our daily lives. To alleviate the sense of helplessness and dread, would the people go so far as to seek salvation in the wicked? This month, a string of serial murders have plagued the country's top-level officials. These heinous crimes are thought to be the work of an unprecedented criminal psychopath, Kamui Uehara. Myriad rumors and speculation abound regarding the suspect, thought to be hiding out somewhere in the 24 wards this very moment. According to some reports, many young people apparently consider Kamui to be some sort of savior. This fanatical support began on the internet and has continued to spread through the real world. Groups of believers, fashioning themselves as revolutionaries, have reportedly appeared as well. We took to the street to see what people have to say. So what do you think about Kamui? Well, he's just so cool. Like, he does what he wants. And that's really sort of attractive, you know? I feel like he gets me. Girl, are you okay? Just because he has some sort of objective doesn't give him the right to act as he pleases. I'm against him myself. I just can't accept what he's doing. Like, is killing people supposed to be the answer to something? I just don't get it. I mean, murder obviously isn't okay, but this man's hair, like, damn. He has, I do feel like working to achieve his goals is kind of respectable. Especially since personally, I'm always just sort of winging it, with no real objectives or anything of my own. The seven victims include the Supreme Advisor to the Ministry of Education, the temporary president of the League of Nations, and more. The killings are considered to be acts of political terrorism. What sort of objective could Kamui have? Flowers are already accumulating at the sites of these gruesome murders, and the sense of grief is palpable. How do related parties view these crimes? We spoke with a top official who was close to many of the victims. I don't know who this guy thinks he is, but I knew many of the victims personally. Put simply, I am enraged. The rumored truths in this matter are nothing but nonsense and lies. Whatever sort of garbage you people are trying to spread, propping up this psychopath as some kind of savior is a crime in itself. Were the crimes perpetrated by this unprecedented serial killer really the work of a single man? What kind of person is the alleged suspect, Kamui Uehara? The mystery only deepens. In searching for some sort of answers, we have obtained valuable information from a man who has met Kamui. More than met him, I guess it would be more accurate to say that I ran into him, rather. I became deeply interested in the man known as Kamui. It's not that I was drawn to him. Not exactly. It's more about what he symbolizes. Like, an ideal? I feel like he set the bar for what we would call perfection, higher than we would have ever been able to. I believe that Kamui feels that if we were able to surpass that bar, we would achieve true perfection. But most people simply don't understand this. They think his ideals are nothing but murder or some kind of fascism. For better or for worse, that's not exactly incorrect. His actions are being watched by all kinds of people. Also, at the very least, he's doing what most can't, so many appreciate and sympathize with that. Some even say he represents hope itself. Wrong game, my dude. Many claim that here, Kamui Point, is where Kamui Uehara was brought up. Under what sort of conditions was this Kamui born and raised, here in this place closed off by snow and almost completely devoid of people? As if to mock them, Kamui Uehara puffed out the lives of important government officials one by one. Now, propagating his invisible power to the people, he continues to grow as a social phenomenon. Just what exactly is Kamui Uehara? A full-fledged terrorist? Just a run-of-the-mill criminal? Or the personification of the end of the millennium? At this point, the truth is a complete mystery. Exactly! Who do they think they are calling these homicides murders? Alright, we are back at the Harakiri batting cages. PM. Oh, another secret meeting. These guys are known as the Trump. This unmarked group of killers who seems to be under Kamui's care is known as a secret society on the west side, but also as secret agents on the east. But I'm wondering, maybe they're connected to this country's government. Government? That's the dumbest shit I've ever heard. Just like Kamui. Another joke. That's it, you know, right? The mystery surrounding Kamui? The rage that followed his appearance? Well, that's ridiculous. He's not some mystical fucking beast. Just a criminal. Alright then. How else do you explain shady organizations that get desperate like Kamui? Of course, idiots like you would turn these shitbags into some sort of fantastic monster. Always the crazy-ass romanticists that get this general public worked up. Can we get the sermon later? Anyway, the Trump affects your people as well. There are troublemakers all over the place, including your group, right? Yeah, well, not interested in coworker-related bullshit. The TRO and CCO are called the Tech Faction and Civic Faction, respectively. The tech side works on development geared toward technology, while the civic side works to maintain the city's purity. They're each opposing organizations. They would never let this spill to the surface. And? Should I give a shit? Figure the rest out for yourself. That's all I can say. So, you just wanted to say that, then keep the rest to yourself? I value my life. So that's all I'll say. At least keep your ass out of trouble. Thanks for the goddamn fairy tale. You're welcome. I don't think Munakata has given us one useful piece of info. Whoa! That's a gun. Why do you got a gun? You said too much. Really? It's just gossip. An exchange of information, you might say. Is that all you've got to say? Are you going to kill me? In that case, just a little more. I can't wait. Dying as a chatterbox isn't very cool, right? Yeah, so you should die with determination, then. Very well. Exactly! Red, save us! Didn't we have the theory last time, though, that Red was actually Kamui Uehara? Alright, into the office. You know, Red would probably make a decent bulletproof vest, actually. Deflect all bullet wounds. Alright, I've got a few announcements. In Heinous Crimes Unit 2, Sumio Kodai has been dismissed. Actually, because of this, Unit 2 is finished. Dobby, you'll be moved to Unit 1. Basically, head over to the main force of the HC unit. Got it? It's an order, right? Yeah, it is. Additionally, the Chief Director Kotobuki has been promoted to Deputy Commissioner, making me, Nakatagawa, your next Chief Director. Let's keep up the good work! A notice from Central. They've started an intense crime eradication campaign. Obviously, this includes dealing with Kamui. Central has doubts about the HC unit's system, so in order to help out our investigators, they felt it necessary to call in a couple of experts. Let me introduce our newcomers. Mikoshiba and Natsume. I'm Kenta Mikoshiba. I'm a transfer from Central's External Affairs Department. Looking forward to working with you all.
I'm Sakura Natsume, formerly of the Special Forces Office. Looking forward to working with you.
Natsume's father is the same Natsume from the Special Forces Unit. I think you know him pretty well, Naegi.
He's helped me out a lot.
So, Mikoshiba, you work with Kusabi. Natsume, you work with Naegi. Are we clear? Yeah, they're not tearing down this dump quite as quickly as they probably should, but, you know. We now have people who are actually watching us do our job, which is probably not a good sign.
And lastly, all HC agents are to head to the International Environment Building. We've received word that Kamui has infiltrated the premises. Lead him to the roof of the building. Don't worry about capturing him. Just make sure he doesn't hurt anyone else. That is what our division does. Dismissed.
Exactly. Any police officer. Ugh. Oversight. Alright, 2:50 p.m. Looks like we're on the roof. Yep. Roof. Sorry, Tetsu. Fine. I'm a positive guy. I'm forward-thinking, or whatever it's called. It's gonna get colder. That's not like you, old man. Strong. That's it. Yeah? Look after Natsume's daughter for me. It'll be tough for Naegi, but... You mean Sakura? Then I guess Natsume's... He hasn't regained consciousness yet. Oh, so he's still alive. Natsume's daughter doesn't know. The department's working in strict secrecy. Why did the department... Those who have encountered Kamui and lived to tell the tale are quite rare. fucking get it. Now he gets the same, right? And that Morishima reporter? Morishima? The news reporter. That's it. Don't dig too deep. There's no going back on this. They're going after Morikawa, too. Ever since that report was leaked, the factions have been coming up to the surface. We're gonna be crushed. Man, don't talk like this. One of those things that, can't be helped. Man? What a joke. Got my hands tied and I can't make a move. What'd you just say? I said it can't be helped. Sorry. It's all FSO. I'm leaving things in your hands now. Oh, shit! Old man. I'll take care of things from here. You just rest easy. Yeah, he's gonna be resting easy on the concrete. But how far involved do we have to get in that? Okay, so the dump might be coming down, because we all die, but, you know, whatever. I know, exactly. We could have at least gotten him a pillow. Like, at the very least, like, he's been our boss for how long? Doesn't he deserve better? Alright, let's start doing some deals with Kamui. Or, I guess, dealing with Kamui. Alright, let's talk to Sakura.
To chase a target down like this? I wonder what my father was thinking at times like this.
Right. This is Commander Morichika Nakategawa of Kamui Elimination Investigation Headquarters. I have an announcement for all agents participating in this mission. Our goal is the disposal of the target, Kamui Uehara. If you find Kamui, lead him to the roof of the International Environment Building. The elimination team will be waiting at an adjacent building. Sharpshooters will be responsible for disposal. Engagement by any other agent is strictly prohibited. Personnel are not to set foot on this roof. Take the beehive and you'll get stung. I repeat, the plan is to dispose of Kamui Uehara. Alright. This plan will cover all bases. I have a feeling that this is going to be one where they talk to me every single time I move again. Starting from the basement, we are to use every available route to make our way to the roof. The phrase, don't let a single rat escape, is to be taken literally. We are to corner Kamui. Once Kamui shows himself on the roof, this is what I get for trying to read a comment and read the game at the same time. Once Kamui shows himself on the roof, that will be the end of our work, folks. The elimination will be carried out by the sharpshooters I mentioned beforehand. Everyone, please proceed with caution. Personnel who do not abide by these orders will be severely punished. I'm just hoping there won't be any screw-ups. Exactly. Sakura has the same name as Makoto's last girlfriend. Let's get along. It's fine. Yeah, the more things change, the more they stay the same. You read me, Nagi? Head to the next floor using that elevator. All the building's controls are linked to the strategic command center. You just have to get in the elevator. We'll be controlling where it goes. You're ready, then quickly get into the elevator.
Come on, Nagi. Let's get a move on.
Alright, we got in the elevator. Alright, looks like we're stopping at the 6th floor. Alright. What's in here? Oh, hello. I can't get in touch with Kasabi. We can pinpoint his location, but he's not responding by radio. He should be somewhere on that floor. Go check it out. Okay. Time to go find Kasabi. Apparently I can't go through that door. big dick. I'm gonna disappear for a bit. There's a lot of crazy shit going on. And, well, I just can't trust anyone anymore. Watch your back, son. You're Natsume's daughter, huh?
I'm Sakura. I looked up to my father. And to you. That's why I chose this job.
Don't get flustered. And trust this. Be suspicious of the truth. The truth and facts are different. That's what I'm after. Big dick. Teach this young lady well. Make her the best. Enough. Get back to the elevator. Okay. Well, that was a weird interaction. Exactly, the elevator just needs more grape and strawberry patterns. It's fine. Alright, back to the elevator. This is Nagatagawa. The main force has pushed Kamui up to the 22nd floor. You patrol the 19th floor. Okay. I will say, I will be very glad when we get out of that funhouse in Danganronpa. Because let me just say, it bugs my eyes. Alright. There's something strange going on with Morikawa's signal. Could be on that floor somewhere. Hurry up and check it out. What are you slacking off for? Kamui's gonna get away. Oh, yeah. You know Tetsu?
I just met him.
I see. Tetsu killed the boss. Condolences. Boss told me to put Tetsu to sleep. Permanently. That was my promise to the boss. Hey, Naegi. Kamui's. Nah. Don't worry about it. Be around. Okay, but what? Okay, so glad everyone else has their own agenda. Oh, great. Let's see what sort of crazy shit Hachisuka says.
Naegi, you haven't seen Tetsu, have you? Morikawa had Tetsu. He had to be stopped. They say Kusabi killed the deputy commissioner Kotobuki. How do you... Just now, Morikawa... Thanks. Please, hold on a moment.
What?
Why are we going after Kamui like this? Isn't there another way for him to... We don't have time to debate crime and punishment. If you want, you can answer those questions in your own thesis or something. Right now, we just need to follow orders.
I just don't understand.
You can understand even without understanding. That is how it is out on these streets. Tell me, please. After Kamui dies, it'll be too late.
Fine then, I'll tell you.
Kamui doesn't mean the person in that body. Even if the body is destroyed, the crime virus that's been spread by Kamui lives in the information people possess. The media amplifies this, encourages it even. Kamui will exist within this society for as long as that virus remains. If we don't stop him, then this virus will never stop. And that is why he must be executed. You can't analyze the mechanics behind crime, because it lurks in the subconscious. Removing Kamui from the people's consciousness requires a truly awful execution. That's why Nakatagawa is leading him to the roof. And to make sure it's all captured live, there are teams of camera crews on standby. Understand?
But why?
The HC unit was created to deal with people. Do you even know what your father did?
My father? What do you mean, what my father did?
I shouldn't tease you so much. You'll understand soon enough. Don't you even try changing the subject! Stupid girls like you really are a pain. I bet you think you can do anything, don't you? Well, good luck. I'm sure it'll be no problem for you.
What the hell does that mean?
Naegi, you understand what Kamui is about, right? Don't you believe him. Kamui is not one with whom you should want to get too familiar. and whatever Nagatagawa is planning is extremely dangerous. The same goes for Kusabi and Morikawa. They're probably getting caught up in some crazy stuff. I just hope you're not one of those frontier types. Also, do something about this stupid girl. I won't forget this. Let that hate marinate. I'll be sure to dispose of you. Bye.
I know, exactly. Like, Hachisuka does not need to tear down another girl boss. So, like, let's go over what we just kind of learned from Hachisuka. So it seems like Kamui is less of a person and more of, like, almost a societal moral, I guess. You know, like, it seems like you see Kamui do something, you get infected with, like, this quote-unquote crime virus, and then you go out and become the next Kamui. Which is, I don't believe how crime actually works, but, we don't know what's going on yet, so. Enough.
Get back to the elevator.
Are we just gonna go around to all of our former coworkers to hear them talk weird shit and...
Nagi, get on the elevator. Head to the 47th floor. We're short on people. Based on how things develop, I might have you meet up with the main force. Take care.
Kamui is a way of life, not a, not a person, apparently. Alright. How many more people can we meet up with? They're all already batshit.
Natsume, have you seen Kusabi? Huh? What is it? You're Naegi, right? Have you seen Kusabi? I got a bad feeling about this. They say that guy killed the former chief director, and Nakategawa told me to dispose of him. Good thing I got this story so quickly. Guess I'm just lucky, huh? Yeah. Hey, Naegi, if you see Kusabi, let me know. You too, Natsume. I don't want Morikawa and Hachisuka getting ahead. I'm counting on you guys. Oh, did you know? Kamui didn't actually kill anyone. I don't really get what's going on here.
Yeah, I don't know exactly what is going on, but everyone's acting a little weird. So, kind of wondering if we're not all kind of infected with the crime virus.
Nagi, there have been some developments. I need you back at the elevator ASAP.
Okay. Why? Every time I go up to the elevator, I learn something horrible new. Something new horrible? I don't know the English for that, but...
You read me? This is Nakategawa.
The main force is cornering Kamui. Make use of that special forces unit experience. Get to the elevator immediately. Move to the 52nd floor. Like, we're all a little bit batty at the moment. No one's acting normal. We're all just acting weird. I think one or all of us are infected with Kamui.
Listen carefully, Maggie. There's a pinpoint on that floor other than Kamui. Go check it out immediately. If necessary, dispose of them.
Them? What's them? I don't want them. Oh, hey! Hey, Morishima.
Been a while, Big Dick.
Sorry, I mean Naegi.
Who are you? A newcomer, huh? A civilian, right?
A civilian? Oh, no, I'm just a journalist.
This area is dangerous. You need to get out of here. There's a possibility you may be mistaken for the suspect.
It's fine, I'm used to it.
You could be killed.
Really? I'm out then.
Please make it quick.
Oh, Naegi, one last thing. I figured out the secrets. All of them. Read the email. Later.
I need you to go. Now.
Alright, alright. Alright, folks. It's time to wrap this mission up. Get back to the elevator. There we go. Kamui is like the Zoom posting memes about the Flash. He used super speed to travel through time and be responsible for everything. I mean, if you think about it, like, there are some things that didn't ever make sense in the original Kamui story. Because, like, when we met the actual Kamui Uehara, we noted that he couldn't have done any of the things that... any of the murders that he had committed, and we just assumed that maybe it was just all Ayame, but... if it wasn't... if Ayame was just, infected by Kamui virus, like... suddenly things make a little more sense. This is the finale, folks. The main force has cornered Kamui on the top floor. Reinforcements, report immediately. Leave the rooftop disposal to the sharpshooters. Move accordingly. Over and out. Alright, let's go see Kamui get shot up. Now that we've figured out that Kamui is a state of mind. We've cornered Kamui on the top floor. Nike, you're the closest. Lead him into the stairwell leading to the roof. You and Natsume split up.
Got it.
Be careful. Exactly, there we go. Alright. Hi, buddy. How you doing? What's up? Got the snipers. It's all scary. What if they all miss? So basically, we're just going to shoot up Kamui and then live stream it to the nation. That's not gonna hurt the national psyche at all. Oh yeah, that man did. Yeah, you know, like, it is a sufficiently boneheaded plan.
November 30th, 1999. Kamui Uehara was shot to death on the roof of the International Environment Building. Kamui's remains, turned into Swiss cheese by the sharpshooters, were quickly dealt with by the crime scene cleanup crew. Following Kamui's death, there were obviously no big changes felt within society. And all those media crews that had followed Kamui so closely were stubbornly silent. As Kamui was executed, so too were the words of the people. And the few who saw hope in Kamui also lost a part of themselves. I, too, lost a part of myself. And so, Gabi, Morikawa, and Chizuru from the 24th Ward's HC unit were never seen again after Kamui's execution. And in the midst of this commotion, a single man kept at his work. It was Naegi.
Yeah, the squishy sounds were a little much. I don't think that's actually what it sounds like when you get shot, but... Alright, so all of our coworkers have fucked off. Our boss is dead. And our new boss has not traditionally cared about us. Alright, Christmas Eve. All right. We read the email. Yeah, exactly. It was like Helsing gunfire. All right, from Tokyo Morishima to us. No subject, no date. I guess that you realize, up until now, we never really got along very well. And now, to be honest, I'm not really sure. But whatever the case, I've decided to trust you. To entrust you with the future, if you don't mind the cliche. But this is not an exaggeration. The future was once something that unexpectedly changed from one hand to another, like the roll of the dice. There's a man called Kinjo. He's an expert in illegal investigations.
and he heads his own illicit organization, and the HC unit has been working with him. Well, actually, the organization is technically legal. Anyway, he should be able to explain quite a few things to you. After that, you'll probably need to understand what it... You'll probably understand what it is you need to do. Or at least that's what I think. And the die will be cast again. Thanks. And I guess you're not so bad after all. Alright. Well, can we go meet with Kinjo? Do I have to look at my computer again? Not so bad after all. Okay. Can I leave? There we go. Alright, let's go chat with Kinjo. Apparently this man has his own building. Apparently Morishima did not like us, yeah. I mean, to be fair, like, he kind of didn't like us after we rescued him. Like, mostly because, you know, he wasn't feeling great after it anyways, and we probably just... The memory of us and the whole thing probably got smashed together, but, apparently he just didn't really like us. Well, let's go to the fourth floor, why not? I don't know where else to go, so... Well, this is a room. This is definitely a room. Hello, sir.
You did well, Naegi. Do you remember me? No, I don't suspect you. Since, you know, we've never met before. Don't be so tense. You've got nothing to worry about. I've got a message from Morikawa. He wanted to see you, but I didn't ask him anything else. So, don't ask me a lot of questions, either. I'm just a messenger. Oh, yeah. I forgot about introductions. I'm Takashi Kinjo. I run a backup shop. Even though Morikawa helped me out, you could say that I've been contracted for a variety of jobs. A backup shop runs illegal investigations, like a private police organization. We mostly work with private businesses. If all goes well, then we just disappear. But if there's a mistake in the plan... The end of the line, literally. Heads are cut, bodies dumped away in a liquid nitrogen tank. Well, all that unfortunate business aside, I've been given a very important job from Morikawa. I'm to entrust all of these riddles to you, Naegi. This might take a minute. Need a bathroom break before we get started? In this city, there are three connected syndicates. Yes, one of them is a syndicate involved in the redevelopment business in the 24 wards. This may sound suspicious, but you know the truth. In the redevelopment business, large amounts of money change hands. And this is a competition to try and take that money. The group that can get this money is guaranteed capital. In other words, they'll have the country in their hands. The 40-year plan for the 24 wards included the relocation of the capital. Government agencies are based in the 24 wards. That makes this the heart of the government. And if you control the heart? That's right. You may use this country in any way you wish. Through the distribution of electricity, by controlling the flow of information, through the arrangement of public transportation. There are games about building cities, right? Separate the land, invest in high-quality properties. Absolute control over administration. It's all a huge game. There was a fight that took place 20 years ago, below the surface of it all. At that time, people from the syndicates were taken out in a series of murders. That is the Silver Case.
Oh, name drop.
The eldest members of the syndicates were killed. So, Silver. A simple name, don't you think? That's when these idiots gave the serial murderer a name. Kamui. And the groups that gave him that name were the Tech Faction and the Civic Faction. The TRO-CCO Alliance. Those factions currently make up a major portion of the police force. Between Central and Public Security, Central represents the Tech Faction's PRO, while Public Security represents the Civic Faction's CCO. This area was originally run by secret societies. It's quite the joke. These two factions created this fictional criminal known as Kamui. The last faction, the Frontier Faction, basically the Conservative Party's FSO. This created a clear distinction in the government's war. Because of Kamui, the Frontier Faction has been forced into disassembly. Kamui doesn't kill people over personal grudges. He kills for the syndicates. It has nothing to do with resentment. It's just a conditioned reflex. This is how the syndicates operate. It's a free-for-all. You fight to win, and if you don't fight, you don't win. The Frontier Faction wants to win, so they'll keep fighting. It's not about goals. It's just a natural instinct. A spat between parties, with each faction trying to outwit the other. A catfight, if you will. A real shit show. It's just that this quarrel has reached a larger scale. That's just how it is. People like Kamui don't really exist. His existence is just an idea. The FSO, the one shaking up the previous agreement between the TRO and CCO, that's the answer to all this turmoil. The FSO are the ones who made this idea real. It took 20 years to create Kamui, and they made many. The Kamui who was executed was just a dummy, and there are many more to replace him. Kamui was manufactured. Through the shelter kids, the FSO finds faithful little pawns. They're raised underground where they become emotionless soldiers. They give their lives to the FSO. That's what Kamui Uehara is. Kamui lives outside of simple existence. If you open that storage device, Kamui will be resurrected. Someone from the Kamui stock will be chosen, and he'll be called back into existence once again. Except next time, the name may not be Kamui Uehara. Sorry, my time is up. It seems I've been called as well. Naegi, I leave the rest to you.
Exactly, the silver case was just a fight to be the winner of capitalism. All right, back to the batting cages. And exactly, we need to escape to space. It's the one place that hasn't been corrupted by capitalism yet. Lover's discourse. What the fuck? You're not dead? I'm not for sure. I wouldn't be done in by such a small fry. That's too bad, eh? Time to settle the score, then? Nah, I'm fine. Actually, I quite like you. I don't want to kill you. Well, look at you. Seems you've grown up, Munakata.
Let's set the jokes aside.
Sure, just for a sec. Hey, maybe you can help me out, huh? Just give me a summary of exactly what the fuck Kamui is. There we go. Kamui is a male Santa role chosen amongst the children of the capitalism cult.
Oh, Tetsu. Just where did you come from?
Huh? What the fuck does that mean?
Your faction.
A fucking politician.
Don't try to hide it.
Hmm? I guess the old man bit the dust.
You killed him, didn't you?
Well, yeah. He was saying something about the FSO.
The FSO are the conservatives.
They used Kamui for their fake world restoration. They're really just trying to recover their political power. The TRO and CCO feign a balancing of power, but when this balance is disturbed, their mutual destruction is inevitable. The FSO is just searching for the chance to wreck the TRO and CCO's relationship. Then the FSO will control the next capital to be the 24 wards. Government? I don't get it. They've all lost their fucking minds.
There are two large syndicates and one tiny one. While the two larger groups go at it, the smaller group is making a grab for the country. And their soldier is Kamui. And this is the real situation.
Hmm. Thanks for keeping it simple. Nice and simple. Anyway, I got it. So, Munakata, what do we do now?
Who knows? Maybe we should just do whatever we please.
Oh yeah? You really think so? Really? So I should just take care of these evil little shits then, right? That'll be easy. I know exactly who to go after. Thanks. Dobby, are you about to pull an Anakin Skywalker and murder all the children? Because, I get where you got there, but it's not really a great look. Glad we're all concerned about it. Like, alright, disciplinary action.
The campaign at the International Environment Building was a success.
Great work, everyone.
Unfortunately, we did lose a few of our own. Dobby and Morikawa. These two abandoned the mission. If you should discover their whereabouts, you have the authorization to dispose of them on site. Hachisuka's already started taking care of preparations for their disposal.
Toshiba, Natsume, I want you two to prioritize their elimination.
This is your debut in the elimination business. Now get this done. With Kamui Uehara's elimination, the crime ring, Trump, was forced to reboot. Now Trump is comprised of four people. Here are the materials. Fox Diamond. Buffalo Heart. Wolf Spade. And Jackal Club. They are experts, so be careful. As it is extremely likely that Trump will try to contact Naegi, I want you to keep your eyes on him, Natsume. Mikoshiba, you use my route to search for their hideout.
But how can we turn on our friends so easily?
Can't be helped. It's not like I want to do it either.
It's just our job. Is this an order?
An order? You could say so. Would that make it easier?
Just do as you're told. Is that really how you feel?
Is that a bad thing? Look, it doesn't matter. This is bullshit.
What's with him? No matter how many orders are given, to come to such a clean decision to just kill a former colleague. There aren't many people who could do that. What do you mean? You're kind of slow. Nakatagawa's upset now. He's upset about having to take out his friends. More than anyone.
I will say Wolfsblade is a very cool name. Like, I don't know how he thought of it, but kudos to him. Yeah, friends is a very liberal term for what the HC unit was. I mean, I guess we all did watch that stream together. Alright, let's see what emails we've gotten today. There is a large amount of this game that is just reading email simulator.
From Takeshi Kinjo
to Superstar.
I deeply regret that lack of hospitality last time we met. I wanted to offer some tea, but I was well aware that it was not the time nor place. And now, on to business. There's a smoke shop called Mulholland, run by a cool old lady. If you go quickly, she should definitely be there. The vending machine is pretty cool, too. It has placebo written on it. I'm pretty sure it should be right next to it. If you're bored, you should stop by for a visit. The future is sure to bloom. Yes, give my regards to the old lady.
Alright, let's go get some smokes, then. We're not even the one that smokes 18 packs a day. Alright, off to Mulholland. Okay. Beyond the door. Oh, this is a nice creepy hallway. feel like we're being, you know, told to come down here and murdered, but... Exactly, the classic secret door behind a vending machine. To be fair, in Japan, that would be a very good place to put a door. Like, no one would ever think twice. Alright, let's start moving. Very slowly. Very, very slowly. Oh my god. Why are we moving so slowly? Exactly, what would they do if we just turned around and didn't continue on? Like... Okay. Well, that's a wall, so I guess we're going this way. Oh, how nice! They have an escalator! Or just stairs. I can't tell. We're not looking too far down. I can't tell if it's stairs or an escalator. Like, it's the right speed for an escalator, but also with as slowly as we walked down that hallway last time, like, it could just be our normal speed. And we're going. And going. And going. Exactly, there we go. For our final battle, we return to the first spot of our journey, the escalator. Oh my god, we finally made it. And watch us have to do it again. No, just another one of these very long hallways. Nagi, you shouldn't go any further than this. It's a trap, and the risk is too great. I'll go back. This can't go on any further. From here on out, it's a different world. Our kind of common sense will be of no use there. It's a strange place. Their mental state is unstable, probably from Kamui's influence. The guy with the glasses? What the hell was his name? Oh, Morikawa. I just got a notebook from him. Seems like it's an important notebook. If I get a chance, I'll show it to you. In the meantime, well, it seems I know too damn much. It's a long road ahead. Naegi, don't die out there. Everything is coming full circle. Sumio, I do still miss you. We haven't heard from you yet, and I don't know what exactly is going on with you. Oh no, another escalator. Exactly, once we find another trashy magazine, that will be when it ends. We can't even get some more flashbacks. Come on, keep going. We can do it. It's a really weird choice, like, to have the entire narrative ramping up, and yet we get stuck in these slow-moving areas. There we go. It'd be funny if they set up a trap, but only on the escalator to our right, which they expected us to use. All right, and another long hallway. All right, here we get some more flashbacks. Alright, on to the platform. Thanatos. Who is the Greek god of death. That's pretty deep. During the redevelopment 20 years ago, there was something made in top secret. Oh, Nike, you made it here in one piece. This will be our last meeting. From now on, the war is on. And I really wanted to get my last will and testament out. Tetsu and Chizuru are both gone. Naigi, you're about the only one left. Will you hear me out? Exactly, thanks for reminding us we need to kick this guy's butt for 100 question kumite. Listen, Naigi, you have to find Kamui. Don't get distracted by the chaos. Search out the truth with your mind's eye. And if you come to know the silver case, read my notebook. I know you can do it. Special train. Nezit 4. All right, let's get on the train that has come for us. Oh, sorry, Morikawa. You didn't end so well. Oh, hey, Kasabi. Can you not shoot me? Because you seem to be shooting all of your other coworkers, and I don't want that to happen to me, honestly. I think it's time for me to go. Exactly. We are leaving everything to Makoto, but a boot to the head for Byakuya. Okay, apparently we're just gonna sit down here. We take a special train for only us, and we still sit and coach. We are not a high-class bitch. Though admittedly, they have not told us that we look like a chinchilla for a while, so... Undeveloped area. Hachisuka Park. There we go. We have an assigned seat on our train ticket, and we can only sit in that seat. All right, and we are at transmitter. Which, for anyone who's forgotten, that is what this section with Big Dick is named. And the other side was placebo, which we already figured out was the cigarettes. Alright. Nice and creepy. In the nowhere. That we can die. Okay. All right, into the mass production center. I will say the red is very aesthetic. That is clearly the important part here. It's where they all make all the baby come away. I mean, mass production center kind of does make it sound that way. All right, the last station. Get out of here. I'm not really quite sure why they let me go out there. But this the Velvet Room? Holy shit.
Don't make such a strange face. Why am I here? I bet you're surprised, right? I'm here to get rid of the humans that are in the way. Maggie, are you going to get in the way? If so, I guess I'll have to get rid of you, but killing humans who don't die isn't much fun. You know what I mean, right? You don't understand? It's fine, don't worry about it. Anyway, have you seen Kasabi? I have to kill that guy. I thought I saw him get on the train earlier, so I was going to ambush him here, but then I would have shot you, Naegi. That was very dangerous. She does clean up very nicely. Like, if only we could have dated her, not, possibly been killed by her. That was very dangerous. Are you here to turn people into murderers? What am I saying? We're already murderers, aren't we? But I really did love Morikawa. Go ahead, shoot. I came after you because I was worried. Let's go, Naegi.
Well, I guess Sakura got her revenge. Right, back to the batting center. East.
Oh, what's this now? To be called on by such an unusual person? The situation must have taken a turn for the better. I'd be happier if it were some reward or something, but anyway, how goes it? Mad nobleman Morichiko Nakategawa of the Frontier Faction?
You know your stuff. That'll shorten your lifespan, you know. Once you know too much.
Well, knowing a lot is how I pay the rent. Besides, people are the ones who feed off of affairs, scandals, and rumors, no matter their age or sex. I'm not wrong, am I?
You're not even close to being useful.
Depending on what happens today, I may dispose of you. Understand? No sense of excitement, huh? If you tell me that from the get-go, then it's just no fun, is it? I've never been one for melodrama. Let's just hurry this up. Talk or die. Pick one. You're TRO, right?
Was I? Maybe.
Wait a sec. Just kidding, just kidding. Where did Kasabi and the rest go? I know you know.
I think they went to your guys' hideout. That familiar place where 20 years were spent in silence.
But why did Kasabi know about
Morikawa, was it?
The guy who went off ahead.
Morikawa.
Thanks.
Well, now I guess I can go, huh?
That won't work.
I thought so. In most cases, I'd be killed.
Yes.
Can you pull the trigger?
Don't worry. You're my 21st.
You keep count.
I'm very methodical. Is that something you say about yourself? Show off your strong points. That's the key to success.
Just like everyone says, quite the eccentric.
I want to hear that from you. Creep who feeds on the lives of young women. Are you talking to yourself? Or to me? Ayame Mazpro stole those girls' future away from her. An enemy of women is also my enemy. So you're a feminist? I'm the secretary for the International Feminist Confederation.
Seriously?
Either way, I cannot forgive you for that.
I picked the wrong target, huh?
In this case, there is no TROCCO or FSO. There was no border between adversaries and allies 20 years ago. You could call it an illusion. Things like factions have no specific shape. You just buy a person's will with money. The revolutionary patriots that came before us are just old men now. These old men just feed on empty theories. We're losing pieces to this game, and that is why we should take away their wealth.
What are you saying? That there was a traitor? That's why Ayame knew?
You still don't get it.
There are no traitors. Then,
Ayame Mazpro, codename Elbow. I saw the draft, and I signed it.
Can't be.
I told you before. You're quite slow on the uptake, aren't you? There is no TRO, no CCO, and no FSO. From the very beginning, there were no factions. It's all part of one big group. If you hadn't planned Project Elbow, then there would have been nothing to carry out. And that is what pisses me off.
You were behind it all.
Me? I'm just another pawn. Someone else is at the top.
Then who is it?
I'm tired of talking. Do you have any last words?
I was Kamui's.
So everyone's killing everyone now.
It's too late. Is all of this idiot's story true?
Most of it, probably. These people only know your face and the leader's face. They're just fighting without knowing who's pulling all the strings.
But in the file, the tech faction and civic faction... Don't fall for what you see in a file. Formal records and official announcements, they're all one big trick. Forgeries and fake evidence are par for the course. So, now what?
These guys are just... They're worker bees. The type of people that can't continue living without someone to fight against.
What do we do next? You're going after the silver case, right? No one cares for your opinion on this.
So, don't do anything stupid.
Let me handle it. Next is Kasabi, right?
Right?
He's connected to the silver case, isn't he? Who else is there?
Shut up, kid. There we go. Imagine if the game was called Project Elbow instead of the silver case. Well.
Tetsu, I'm leaving it up to you.
That's good, because we are very rapidly running out of cast members.
Let's move in. Many years ago, human testing projects took place in the shelter environment here. The government created the new International Environment Agency as a scapegoat.
One part of that generation raised the flag to the cultivation of the new human. The International Environment Agency. To most, they seemed to be working for the protection of nature and the environment, but they were also working to improve the human condition. That is to say, they wanted to improve the lives of those living in the wards. But below the surface, they were removing ward residents who were deemed unsuitable. After checking for ward residents with a high propensity for criminal behavior, they would turn these people into data, search them out, and slowly take over. This unbelievable plan was executed over the course of 20 years.
Yeah, Sakura seems to be our player too, and I'm not against it.
Those living within the 24 wards right now are its most suitable residents. And the instrument necessary to the prevention of crime in the 24 wards is the Heinous Crimes Unit. You were a member. The Special Forces Unit my father supervised was another part. The goal of this agency was to dispose of negative elements, and an experiment that was used to assert absolute control over the 24 wards. And they were not only involved in elimination, they also had a hand in raising and educating kids.
Yeah, this really does just boil down to eugenics.
That was the Shelter Kids policy. The location we're heading to now is ground zero for this entire operation. This is where most of the children live until they're released out into society. In the last 4 years of this plan, 1,440 children have been released out into various ways of life. They lead normal lives while being controlled. They live at the central organization while being controlled. They're used as samples, then go from being controlled to being set free, where they control their lives on their own. For some of them, their names are erased, and they're assigned to the Special Forces. They're placed under the control of the Central PD. All memories of their past are erased. It's different than the goal for Kamui. These samples are for the research and development of criminal power. It's a tragedy. To control life like that, making Kamui believe he has something to live for, when actually, there's nothing. That's you, Naegi. You're a human that's been manufactured.
We got manufactured and we still look like a chinchilla?
Kamui doesn't exist within the realities of the residents. He is a manufactured human, like yourself. To be more precise, you are Kamui too. The stock for Kamui are the Shelter Kids. Even if Kamui is destroyed, Kamui's life isn't over. There are plenty left to inherit his legacy. Even if all the stock is destroyed, Kamui won't disappear. If the next generation of stock is born, then Kamui will be reborn. And not only Kamui, there is another policy in effect. Kamui is the male stock unit. There's a female unit that exists as well. Ayame Maspro. That's right. The Ayame serial murderer that confined Kamui is Ayame. That girl is a sample Ayame. Their stock of 1,440 girls. The three women she killed were also Ayame. The Chizuru who I killed was also Ayame. He was a sacrifice of her father, Mayor Hachisuka, and was the first subject of this experiment.
That is so sad.
And I too am also...
Exactly. You'd think that they'd get the message that criminal behavior is being hereditary is outdated science. But then again, dominant power structure probably relies on both bogus science. Like everything else, right? Chizuru definitely deserved better, like, let me just say.
This is our hometown. We don't have memories of this place, but we spent about 4 years living here. 4 years after you guys were sent out as the Kamui generation, the Ayame generation was sent in here. My father told me, I will likely be killed by someone raised here. It seems my father wanted to be killed by Ayame, and so that's how things became what they are. The top of this shelter is a TV tower. It overlooks all of the 24 wards. It's a tough tower. The ones with all the power created it as a symbol of control. If you open that path, then this shelter is the key. It's like a video game, you know? In some ways, it does resemble a game. By bearing the responsibility for such an unnatural upbringing, that itself becomes a game. From here on, please continue alone, Kamui.
I don't want you to start calling me Kamui. Exactly. As long as we're Kyoko, we're fine. Let's see. How do I do that? We got Dance in the Dark! I mean, we did say that, you know, when we found another crappy magazine, that it would come full circle. All right. Into one. Residential area. Triangle Tower 1. Forgot I have to hit that in order to move. And up we go. At least these aren't stairs, I guess. I can't go in any of these doors, so... Aha! Found one I can go in. There doesn't seem to be anything in it, but... Report. From the inspection implemented after the shelter-wide test the other day, in which the HEART team had a concentration of reactive members, the Education Administration Office and General Administration Office sent orders to revise the manual. Details will be decided upon tomorrow. I know, exactly! Finally, a wheelchair-accessible ramp. Page 5. The process for ocular silverization is to be discovered and controlled. This is the main goal of the current plan. AM and AM are not at all experimental. All employees should stay vigilant and keep going about their duties. Shelter Kids Policy Implementation Office Administrator Kaiji Enzawa. Enzawa, that name sounds really familiar. Wasn't that who we figured out the bat was, or at least the name he was using? Nothing in this one. I guess I can check the other ones to make sure that nothing there. I don't see anything here. So apparently I could go in it, it just wasn't letting me at the time. Alright, page 2. Regarding the process progress. The male children with positive genes who are gathered are split into 4 groups, and each group consumes an individually tailored curriculum. The results for each group are compared, and the most effective curriculum is expanded. Also, high-result groups are provided with concentrated education. For details on the curriculum, see the attached Sheet A chart on page 78. Exactly! This is the grand plan, to replace FM radio with KM radio. What a dastardly master plan. Page 1. The significant difference detected in Kamui Uehara's cellular age is not due to a problem with the equipment. Kamui Uehara, referred to as K-Below, left eyeball DNA test results confirmed that said eyeball is not K's own. Great, so he was just chilling with someone else's eye. Neat. Okay.
Like, why? Leave people's eyeballs alone. Okay, nothing in here. I love when they give me places to look and then they give me nothing. Exactly, there we go. Is this going to be like the Master of Masters putting his eyeball in a keyblade so we can see the future? Maybe. We don't know yet. Oh my god, we have so many towers to go through. Alright. Page 5, Edition 2. Administrators are to, with regards to curriculum and education, ensure that there are no mistakes and that there are no problems in the system. If this cannot be done, then in accordance with a superior's decision, administrators may be processed without warning. This must be remembered at all times. Exactly, the Master of Masters is coming ahead of. We figured out Kingdom Hearts. Page 1. Ayame Maspero, AM, is to strive for the ocular silverization that KM could not achieve. Important data gathered from KM shall be used as a basis for administration. So basically, Ayame was the successful, or the improved 2.0. They really said girls can do it better. And when they said that, they meant war crimes. There we go. The silver case is actually a silver briefcase contained inside the black box Lushu was guarding. Alright, page 2. According to notes left in the personal management notes, when Kay was 2 years old, he received a transplant for his left eyeball. At this time, the transplanted left eyeball was said not to have been that of a primate, but it is still unknown exactly what said eyeball came from. They were just putting eyes in things, it's fine. Report. It has been confirmed that there is no large difference in eyeball response rate between genders. This project is considered to complete and will finish as of 11 p.m. tomorrow. Also, all related documents are to be destroyed by that time. Also, the security force shall handle the processing of all employees under Level B. There we go. That's the lesson they took from Margaret Thatcher. Only girl bosses have enough girl power to effectively commit war crimes. Sorry, girls just commit war crimes better. It's just a proven fact. Really, you make me go all the way up here and there's nothing in the top one. All right, and back down we go. We have finished 2. We have like 10 of these to go through. Whoever designed this needs to be shot. Yeah, this is exactly why the patriarchy refuses to allow women to have power. Alright. And up we go! Tower 3! We just have the Spark Notes version. Like, this is so unnecessary. Nothing in there.
Step 185, Educational Direction. Today's job, find the blocks that fit into the holes on the panel from the box and fill in all the holes. Once the panel is filled, get a new panel from the teacher. Keep going until the teacher says to stop. When this job is done, get a sticker from the teacher. Report. This is for those for whom eyeball removal surgery is possible, 99 PPL. All are thought to be able to undergo the surgery. Ew, eyeball removal? Yeah, exactly. Like, someone has to go through the whole thing in order to make the Spark Notes, so if someone wants to make a Spark Notes version from this, please feel free. We need a TLDR. There. There better be something in this top floor this time. Communication. The Education Administration Manual is to be revised. The new version can be exchanged for the old version at the Administration Office Windows 8 through 15. Super glad we had to read that one. Good. There is one at the top. Notice. Health checks will be performed. When your name is called, line up in order. Follow the teacher and go to your health check. If your name is not called, you have work to do. Pay attention to the teacher's instructions. Alright, and back down we go. Exactly, if they don't have a new pet puppy waiting for us at the top floor, like, how dare they? I understand we're learning about eugenics and war crimes and all of that, but I think after all of this and all the walking we're having to do, we deserve a puppy. Because right now I'm getting the vibe that we're probably going to die at the end of this. All right, on to four. We're almost halfway there. There we go, this should be a water slide. Report, ocular inspection results. Nobody tested had ocular responses, but there are 28 people for whom ocular treatment may be possible. Communication, full examinations will be performed. All those with grades of AA or higher are applicable. Administrators are to send all those applicable to Administration Office 5 by 8:30 a.m. tomorrow. Dates and details will be provided later. You know what really gets me is that it's the empty rooms. Like, how dare you? You really think I wanted to come in here to look at nothing? Step 7, Educational Direction. Today's job. After the teacher signal, all electricity will go out. Until it returns, do not speak or make a sound. Once the lights are back on, get a sticker from the teacher. To administrators, goals have changed. Implementation time has been changed from 8 hours to 14 hours. Please see the attached documents for details. Notice, classes will be changed. When your name is called, get your things together. You will move to your new classes in order. If your name is not called, you have work to do. Pay attention to the teacher's instructions. Thank you.
I mean, technically, I don't think they'd do anything if we just stopped going up and decided to take a nap. Like, oh, hey, there's something over here. Oh, hey, buddy. How you doing? Other than not very well. Wonder how many of those we've missed. Don't see any of them here, so. All right. Down the slide we go. We found one dead body. But hey, it's only one in four buildings, so that's something, maybe? I feel like it's not, but all right, five. Halfway there. There we go. New Game Plus is just faster walking speed on this. Seriously, who decided that this was a good idea? Because I'd like to have some words with them. Report number 01729. Ocular response confirmed. They do look super uncomfortable. That, then again, this is like a shelter project, so I can't imagine the government is pouring money into these children that they're performing war crime experiments on. Report. Inspection report meeting scheduled. In accordance with the previous inspection, the spade team's results were found to be more suitable than other teams. My eyes are getting very tired. All right, nothing in there. Report number 00038, ocular response disappeared. Number 00032, 34, and 35, ocular response strengthens. Relation is unknown. Report. Reported as a possibility in the previous report. Number 00087 has been found to have had a mistake in their checkup by the administrator. The subject is to be tested again and data to be regathered and fixed, and this is to be requested today. The new data is set to be distributed tomorrow night. Also, the administrator responsible has been processed. I don't know what processing means, but it doesn't sound pleasant, whatever it is. And back down we go. Okay, so we've finished half of them now. So just five more to do. And all we've learned about is eyes. All right, on to number six. Nothing there. Nothing there. We are gonna need new eyes by the end of this. A lot of reading and looking around.
Page 1. Kamui Maspro, KM, his biggest goal is in the analysis of ocular silverization. The silverization gene confirmed in previous research only occurs under specific conditions. Report. Regarding AM results. Among 1,440 applicable female children, a total of 809 had the gene confirmed. Among these 809 people, 329 people had the ocular surgery. Among them, ocular silverization occurred in 0 people.
To the top of this tower.
Page 2. Period of 4 years. Female children with the positive gene are applicable. Curriculum has been unified. High achievers and those with many of the applicable traits shall be provided with concentrated education. For curriculum details, refer to Chart 67 on attached Document A. Page 3. In order to clarify ocular silverization and eyeball transplants, this project is to officially begin.
Okay. Well, we already knew they were doing war crimes. Like, that's nothing new. And down we go. Is this why Sakura abandoned us? She was like, I do not want to do all of this walking. She was just like, fuck, I'm out. Alright, into Tower 7.
Notice, your sticker books will be collected. Please get a new sticker book from the teacher.
Here we go. First eugenics, then war crimes, then denying education to those without a certain eye color.
Report. Educational revision. The current version of the educational guidelines are thought to be lacking and have promptly been revised based on new research.
Be finding another dead body over here. Yep. Sorry, buddy. Don't know who you are, but you're obviously not having a great time, whoever you are. That's 2 dead bodies in 7. A little bit higher percentage.
Notification. This project is to be completely finished. All manuals and other related documents are being destroyed within 7 days from now. Step 26, Educational Direction. Today's job. The box contains many cards. Collect all cards of the color specified by the teacher.
Once finished, get a sticker from the teacher.
There we go. Notice. Flush the evidence down the toilet. Let me just say, if they disposed of all the evidence, they did a really shitty job, considering how many of these I have picked up from the floor. Alright. 7, done. And down we keep going. We're like 3/4 of the way done. We've just spent like half an hour on this already. Probably not that long. It just feels like that long. All right, just 3 more left. Exactly. Why couldn't this just be an elevator or a conversation? Like, hey, look at all these documents we collected from these 8 or 10 towers. Look, there's stuff about war crimes in them. Report, Shelter's Kids Policy. Neither KM nor AM achieved ocular silverization, which is unfortunate. But while it wasn't fully achieved, there were 272 people who made it to the step before that, and it is felt that this is close enough to be considered successful. This policy is to be enacted once again. Shelter Kids Implementation Office Administrator Kaiji Anzawa. Page 4. Mass production of mental clones needs subjects close to K before ocular silverization, and children found to have the required gene are to be watched over in the shelter and provided with 4 years of curriculum-based education. A lot of these memos seem to be saying very similar things to other memos that we've already read, or, you know, stuff that we heard from Natsume, or from Sakura. Page 3. Each group is to have an administrator. 108 people are to be split among 3 schools. Administrators of groups with at least 25% of members considered unsuitable are to be processed by the applicable office. Also, children found unsuitable shall be similarly processed. All employees are to abide by this. The children too? Like, damn, that's cold. Page 4, addition. Male children applicable for education will not be increased, but if mistakes are found in the curriculum, they may be increased with permission from an administrator. Back out. There we go. Any teacher with a C minus grade average will be sacked and dissolved. That just makes me think they're just dangling them over acid. All right, 8 is done. And down we go. Seriously, this could have been a fun little water slide minigame, and they decided to make us watch the walk-in animation instead. Maybe it's to make us have time to process, but like, I don't need to do that much processing. They did some fucked up shit. I'm one of those people that was experimented on. Alright, 9. Almost there. We're gonna get to 10 and find out there's like another 30 behind that. Exactly, there's not much to process when they say the same thing. Report, administrator room. No possible ocular subjects.
No changes in physical suitability. However, slight drops in immune system have been found. In accordance with item 88, the following have been found to have reached their limit. Number 00987, 08989. Numbers are awful in a second language for anyone who doesn't speak a second language. 98300, fine. Notification, with the start of this project, former project members are to report to the administration office meeting room by 5:30 p.m. tomorrow. Like, literally, I do not need time to process that. That does not seem to be relevant to me. Yeah, really.
Notice, tomorrow is cleaning day. Please be sure not to lose your stuff while cleaning up.
Yeah, I know. Like, I'm terrified Sakura's gonna be like, so, what about that note that you found in, you know, building 300?
Step 92, educational direction. Today's job. Draw whatever picture you like in the sketchbook you received from the teacher. Keep drawing until the teacher says to stop. When finished, show the teacher and receive a sticker.
Up we keep going. There. Or she'll ask a question like, what color were the beds on the second row? And I'll be like, I have no idea. I didn't pay enough attention to that. All right, 9 is finished. Seriously, what if Sakura went through all this, then left each note in the room she found it, and went, if I had to go through that, someone else has to know my pain too. Like, that is petty enough that I would do it too, so, like, no shade, but... And we're going. All right, last one. Until they reveal that there has been another 25 behind it.
Page 5. Identification of the ocular silverization mechanism has been the dream of humanity for years. This is a huge step towards immortality. Shelter Kids Policy Administration Implementation Office Administrator Kaiji Anzawa.
Oh, now you want immortality? Like, my dude. You're not gonna get it by gouging out children's eyes.
Page 4, from the Implementation Office Manager. For the implementation of AM, all employees must be on the same page. Our goal is the recreation of ocular silverization. For KM, thanks to all your hard work and research, we were able to confirm the existence of the process, but that is not our final goal.
There we go. We do need a giant bowling ball to knock all these towers down. They need to come down anyways, let's be honest. Anywhere that war crimes have been done probably shouldn't be staying up.
Come on, last tower. Last tower. Page 3. Each group is to have an administrator. 108 people are to be split among 3 schools. Full education is to be implemented. For male children in whom the particular gene is strong, ocular transplants are to be implemented. In some situations, transplants may be carried out several times. Holy shit. Be sure to pay close attention to the subject's health and physical condition. For details on administration, refer to attached material 2.
They could have spread these out throughout the game, like the ANSM reports, or also, they could have just put us in a fucking library.
Oops, damn it. I missed one, but I'll get it after I... Okay, I'll get it on the way back. Of course nothing in there. All right, report regarding KM results. Amongst 1,440 applicable male children, a total of 778 had the gene confirmed. Among these 778 people, 389 had the ocular surgery. Amongst them, ocular silverization occurred in 0 people. Okay, let's blow this popsicle stand. It is time to go. And never go in these damn towers again. Five equals 7 plus 3 minus 9 plus 4. What the fuck does that mean? I don't seem to be able to do anything with this. Okay, spade, diamond. Heart, club. Yeah, pretty much. This entire project was a waste of money and accomplished nothing but screwed up children. And I'm going to look up what the hell I have to do here because I am so confused and I'm not going through all that again. Let's family drum. Photo pattern. Rachel, looking for yellow star markers lining the axis of each. Oh my god. So apparently there are 5 dead bodies somewhere in there. Oh my god. Okay. Okay, so 5, 7, 3, 9, and 4. This is hell. Can I figure out which ones there are? And 3, 9, and 4. Okay. The red dots correspond to what needs to be looked at still. What red dots? Okay, so we found 5. We need 3.
A 9, I think, based on this. Oh my god. Alright, well, back into 3. Okay, nothing in here. Nothing in there. The only hell is not having to do it once, but having to do it twice. Okay. Read that one. Read that one for eyeball removal surgery. Wasn't gonna forget that one anytime soon. Ain't nothing in there. Aha. Okay, found that dead body. Not entirely sure why I have to go find all the dead bodies. This is a fucked up game of hide and seek, but... we just gotta find all the war crimes in here. I'm pretty sure, just based off of the ones that we've seen, that these have to be those Trump members that Nakatagawa was talking about earlier. You know, the spiky club spade things. I could be wrong, but that kind of seems likely. Which I guess the question becomes, why are they down here? So I know that we saw all of the ones in the middle, and I'm just looking for the ones on the side. If you're gonna kill someone, like, at least have the decency to just leave them out in the middle of nowhere. All right. 5. You have found all 5 bodies. Time to go. And never go in these damn towers again. Love how I had to do all of this. Logically, what would happen in the story next if we just decided to stop searching these towers and talk to Sakura again? Yeah, I mean, to be fair, like, oops, damn it. Apparently we are going back in this tower again because I hit the wrong button. You know, like, she can't make us go anywhere. Okay, you want us to go in that one? Five. Now what? Tempted to just start at the top and work my way down. Oh, hey, Kasabi! This world was engraved in Kamui's mind. This is the 20-year curse that haunted him. But that's normal. As far as this unbelievable story is concerned, Hines, you're no idiot. But real people? Forced to live in a place like this? It's unnerving knowing that someone could get used to it. Living in a strange place like the 24 wards, surrounded by these weird environments, places like this aren't so far-fetched. I mean, really. All this underworld a huge crime has nothing to do with this actual place. The problem is the business of the organizations. But seeing as things have turned out like this, if you were to ask me what's the point of the work I do, I wouldn't feel bitter. Or like, at peace, I guess. Like how you feel when a cool breeze flows by. It's a pleasant feeling, at least for old guys like me. I don't have a fire to fuel my anger. Putting on this carefree front is the natural way of it. And, well, if you were to ask what do we do now? We find our enemy, we take him out. Look at the dead bodies of these murderers. These guys were residents, and now they've died in the place that they once called home. This is the end of the road for the stock. I guess you could call it a safety measure. These dummies are necessary when going from one Kamui to the next. What do you think would happen if you were to kill them? There would be no buffer when going to the next Kamui. There would be nothing. There would just be fewer Kamui. Every time a new Kamui appears, there should always be something akin to a ceremonial custom. Enormous amounts of information must be sent out, to the extent of whatever the communication method can handle. That's not a simple process. We're talking about getting an injection of a very complex source. That's why the next Kamui would come here. Those Trump guys are the guard dogs. They're the ones who protect Kamui. And that's why I killed them, so that they wouldn't get in the way. I have to meet the next Kamui. I want him to show himself before me. I want to be face to face with Kamui. Exactly. No wonder Kamui went mad when he had to deal with this shit. Glad you could make it, Kamui. Excuse me? Excuse me? Sir, I don't want to be the next Kamui. Please, sir, not me. Please pick someone else. Fitting, since apparently we've all met a bad end, but, this place, created for fun by the elder members, symbol of political power. It took in large amounts of tainted money, like a luxurious elderly home. And then, 20 years ago, a silver case occurred in the very same location. And it was carried out by a hitman called Kamui. This Kamui was the original form of Kamui. The perpetrator, Kamui Uehara. He was called the Format Kamui. He was the trump card of the FSO Frontier Conservative Party. He went to the radical TRO and CCO Tech Civic Reform Alliance, where all their most important leaders gathered. Snuck into the TV tower all alone and killed every one of the elders. A high-powered pistol in each hand. He just stood there, river of blood. And so, I shot and killed him. Uehara didn't put up any kind of resistance. He just smiled. That is the silver case. The only ones that know the truth are me, the old man, and Munakata. Just us three. The man known as Kamui Uehara was real, but his birth record wasn't even on the government's host. Uehara was never a human after all. That's what I've been thinking right now. But I don't understand. Silver was never made public. After that case, the TV tower was closed.
It became a tower run completely by computer, no people. Simply put, it was changed into a relay tower. All the young folks were excited. It was some kind of bait spot.
Exactly. Kusabi was going to put us through hell at some point after he sat there and just, you know, talked to us during that one mission, but... like, at the very least, he could have been nice and just left them dying dead, you know, like, right in the middle of the tower. Alright, the elevator is stopping. Where to? However, there's one door I couldn't open. I shot it, but it never budged an inch. He didn't seem to mind at all. What the fuck was that? Huh, I'm sure I'll understand soon. Alright, the rooftop graveyard.
Graveyard filled with the elderly. Probably. There's no going back.
Nothing happens. Okay. Then nothing happens.
Look out at this telescope.
That's a 7. Nothing happens. Something appears to have been set. Okay. 8. Something appears to have been set. We're going to accidentally get this, it's fine. Okay, that one says 1. Happens. They could have put this in a little higher definition. Happens. I can't tell what that number was. Happens. Alright, this one... okay, so that's either a 9 or an 8. I think that's an 8. Exactly. Like, I assume that's why we have Kusabi here. Okay, so... 1. Something appears to have been set. Can't tell what that other one was. Happens. Nine. Must have been 9. They are banking on Kyoko's notorious ability to remember her movement controls. Because that's what I do absolutely best. All right. Go to the creepy stairway. Don't get tense, Kamui. Just relax. Stop calling me Kamui. I miss Big Dick, and I didn't think I'd ever say that. Look at those giant hard disks. Okay. Congratulations. All right, into the black box. We finally made it here after 20 years. Family. And I'll just keep calling you Big Dick. No matter whether you do or don't become Kamui, it's up to you. So, what do you do? If you kill him, you can release yourself from this curse. Will you live by killing your past? Or will you die clinging to your past? Can you keep moving forward? Can you live after facing your true self? Decide here and here and now, Big Dick. You were born with a set of balls. You keep living like it means something. No, but that's okay. Pull the trigger on the devil's gun. Destroy the darkness. Seize the light. Oh, we fired. Exactly, we are so tired. It's finished. Anything and everything. I just want to go the fuck home. No longer, Akemi. I keep forgetting he has a daughter that he actually does really love. Alright, Christmas! Because we had a hell of a Christmas Eve. Where most of our friends died. Quote unquote friends. Alright, 2 Grand Slam. That was a close one. What happened to Naegi? Naegi? Is there someone by that name? I forget. Looks like the mystery was solved. I guess Kamui never existed. Nope, he's alive. Inside Naegi? It's not as romantic as you're making it out to be. Just fate. Yes, it's like the rumor said. So, Naegi's the format, Kamui? I don't know about that shit, but maybe this Kamui had as the total sum of everyone else's existence. Since so many others were sacrificed for him, there were probably many more who were never rewarded. Maybe he inherited Kamui so that the memories of his youth wouldn't be forgotten. What do you think? That's it. There is such a thing as knowing too much. You're a nice guy, alright? No. I understand. There. Satisfied? Isn't that right, Naegi? I've been thinking. What if you'd been in a terrible environment? Or if there'd been some problem with your upbringing, then it really wouldn't be your fault completely. I mean, I'm in no position to talk, but there are a lot of crimes, guilt, and flaws. These are things you can just erase away. Definitely not one's shadows. Erasing one's memory is cheating, of course. They say people are equal, right? That means we all have the same terms. And there are shadows that you can't just erase away. There are footprints to the shadows written in ink. For me, and for you. Doesn't matter if your name. Sapi, Naegi, Kamui. To the spirit that resides in us all. Within that spirit, there's a light of possibility. There is no distinction there. If it takes some time, the light is there. There are even lights with shortcuts. But the light will never change.
The light and shadow exist in harmony. And that's why it's up to you. Facing the shadows, facing the light. Don't get it twisted. I'm not talking about good and evil. I'm talking about a light that can be grasped by anyone. A light that brings along the shadows. Feel the shadow, give birth to the light. Find the light within your spirit. Use that fucking light, Nike.
Okay, so we did go, like, very Kingdom Hearts there for at the end. Exactly, we refused to die while Kasabi's still breathing. Alright, and we have finished Life Cut. Tamura is coming soon. World in Motion. Okay, so we, I believe, are almost done with this game. We are going to end here for tonight because I am done after looking through all of those places. But, so next stream is Tuesday, because today is technically Monday now, but Tuesday at 10 o'clock Eastern, 7 o'clock Pacific. We should, I'm assuming, at least have Lemur. I don't know about Mana this week. I'm going to assume we're not going to see them much. Do remember, if you are going to MetroCon, go see Mana. Let's see. Yeah, because I think Tamura... No, we have Hikari there. And we have a special case there. Okay, yeah, so we are getting close to the end. Let's see. Means that we are going to have another solo game that we'll need to figure out. There is a sequel to this game. If we want to go there, or if we want to take a break and do something else, let me know in the chat. Quick reminder that we do have Twitter for any updates on, you know, whether we start late or whatever. And we have a YouTube channel if you have missed a game that we have played that you might be interested in watching, or pretty much anything. If you missed anything, go check out the YouTube channel. Pretty much everything is on there except for the occasional demo. Let's see. Yep, Mana will be at MetroCon this week, so go support them. Send them as much love as possible. They're doing so much work, so, you know. Please go appreciate them. Give them your love. We are cheering for them while I sit here on the sidelines and play video games. I think that's the only announcement I can think of. See you guys on Tuesday. Have a good night. Wash your hands, wear your masks, get vaccinated, and sleep well. Bye.